All right, should be live. Cool. Pull up the reference. Jeez. Yo, yo, what's up, Terry? Jesse, Chris Astro, how's it going? Just still trying to set things up here, one sec. Oh man, that has to be the worst reference, but it'll work, I guess. Wait, let me see if I can find a... That's better. Let's see.
Sorry.
Yeah, there you go. It's gonna be the full tutorial. Well, as full as it can get, I guess. Yeah, okay, that's a way better one. Cool. So, as you guys can see, I have the stencil set up here. I don't know if you guys, there you go. You can see that it's on there. You can't really see the design. But if you look up the LA Times Kobe, that's pretty much all I searched for. And it's the very first picture that pops up. So, I'm just going to start off by going through with my bottom feed air brushes and going through the colors here and kind of adding in the colors that I see. So I'm going to start with the dark brown, and it's going to be kind of weird because I'm working on the stencil. Alright, so I'm just going to be careful to keep the brown within the brown area. Because I don't know where exactly these cuts are, I'm just going to cover these whole areas that I see that are brown. Because, yeah, again, I can't see where these cuts are. And some of them are so tiny that, you know, it's better just hit the whole area. His sleeve is white here, but his arm is brown. Trying to use the light the best that I can to kind of see these areas. But like I said, some of these cuts are just so small. These stencils are so defined that it's legitimately easy to get lost. I'm starting with the dark color because I don't expect much of it to go through. Okay, so that's that. That would have been yellow. Let's load up some yellow. Jersey. Again, I don't know what actually shows through. We're just kind of hoping for the best here. That might be a good thing with these stencils or a bad thing. I don't know. So I'm just trying to keep my hopes up that some of this will show. If not, we're spraying yellow for no reason, but I don't think that's the case. Maybe I am, I don't know. It seems like I am. I don't know. It's hard to tell. But let's see what else. Let's do some gray. We are working on an illustration board today. That's why I have it all taped up. But I would definitely recommend, if you're gonna order some of these stencils, that you get yourself a nice fine surface to work on, because you will be leaving detail and stuff behind, even working on canvas, because the texture of the canvas really works against the stencil. Okay, now let's do some purple. Saludos, Ricardo. What else are we missing? I think I'm just going to use gray to kind of finish off those white areas. Again, we're kind of going uncharted territory here because I don't even think HD Stencils kind of has figured out a way to make them in color. I try to find a good video of it. Actually, I'm just gonna go back with some black real quick, just to hit a few spots. Actually, I just missed the purple on this band here. Cool. So let's just do that little bit of purple there. Then we can peel our stencil back. And I have it taped down so we can move it, but we'll be able to get it right back in place so long as we don't untape it completely. Alright. So let's see what we got here again. What's up, Corey Duncan? Juan Camilo Montoya, saludos. Alright, so we're just gonna take this. Let's see what we got here. Yep, and just like I thought. Let me tape it back there. Cool. So that actually works pretty good, I guess. Sorta. Now I just gotta go back in and fill all this in, as well as these little details here. I feel like it might actually just be better to go in with some gray. Wait. Again, experimentation here. I'm just gonna let that drop right back down where it was. I'm just gonna take a little bit of black. Hit this area now. Let's see. Yeah, I think that'll work a little bit better, actually. Get some of that yellow in there, but the black really just kind of sets it into place. Yeah, that actually looks pretty good. And where now we go over with transparency, it'll be pretty nice. You can kind of see the little squares from the grid of the stencil. You want to see it? Pretty cool, huh?
Very cool.
Yeah, now let's see if we could fill in the rest of it without... And we have the stencil in place, so if we need to go back and do some work, we can. But from here, I'm going to switch off to my top feed. So, I think I'm just going to start off by doing the yellow. Throw some reducer in here. Throw some yellow in here. Okay, Ricardo's. Suerte. So, let's see here. What do we got? What do we got? What do we got? I don't know about all that, because... Me and my wife got into, we were discussing this earlier, about how if you order one of these stencils, right, and yeah, most people will watch this or watch the video of me trying it and just order it and then spray it and then remove it and be done. And there's really nothing wrong with that if you want to use it like a silk screen. But on a piece of art like this one, where I want to fill it in, I want to detail it, you better be damn sure you could match the detail of the stencil. That's all I'm going to say. If you can't, you're going to have a hell of a time. Right? Because the stencil just lays the base down. And even though it lays a really good base, it's still just the base. Then you got to go back in like this and fill it all in, but it gives you a really good idea of where to put them, where to put everything, right? But I could see a lot of people just ordering them and like they just want to use it like a silk screen, you know. But at that point, you're not really an artist, you're just a really good silk screener, kind of. We came to that conclusion that you better be able to match the stencil detail is because if you lay this stencil down, right, and you get this really nice transfer, and then you start adding strokes in there that are not the same detail as the stencil, you're going to start making it look muddy and ugly, and you might end up with an uglier picture than if you would have just, you know, done some kind of transfer or, like, drawn it on and actually just, you know, done a piece of art. Whereas this is kind of more like a replica kind of, right? It's not, I'm not really, there's nothing artistic about it. I'm just following this stencil. Like, there's no creativity involved. It does make it easy, though. And it's probably going to look like a really good piece of art when I'm done. Like this. Because, again, I'm going through and doing all the detail, you know. Which, it's going to start by filling in these colors, and then I got to go back in and, you know, fill in the rest of it. Like, even though everything's there, it's not 100% still. I don't know. I could go on about stencils all day, but it is just a stencil at the end of the day. It's not just one and done, you know? Still takes work. Little white outline around it. Oh my gosh. See, the stencil did make that easier, like getting that little white outline on that Lakers. Wow, let me see. It looks crazy curly from here. Wow, that does look good. You need to put them up higher, though.
Well, yeah, but I need to order, like, enough to do my hair.
Yeah. You need to put them all the way up to your scalp, though, it seems like.
You know how hard it is with only two hands.
But like I said in that video, if you plan to do, like, a Madonna, right? Or, like, no, not Madonna's a bad example. If you've done Marilyn Monroe, right, and you want to do it on the side of a gas tank, and you want it to be the same, like, exactly the same on both sides, this is probably the best way to achieve that right now. Like, you know, I've done lots of tricks to get those images the same, you know, and I've shown it before. But, this is just way better because it literally lays out all the shading lines and everything for you, so you don't have to do much thinking. You just spray, you know. Yeah, Terry, they're nice stencils, man. And Gerardo, he's a pretty cool guy. Yeah, you know. I sent him a link to this and let him know I was going live. I don't know if he's in the chat, but if you go back on those videos, you drop the comments. I definitely recommend going and subscribing to him. And me and him just been having conversations in the background. And he's like me. He's one of those guys that paints and doesn't have to put everything on YouTube. He's been doing a lot of motorcycles and stuff. He does pretty good work. You need an airbrush artist in Connecticut. I would recommend him. He's especially since he has access to making these stencils, however the hell he makes them. But I can almost guarantee that whatever you order from him is probably going to come out pretty good just because of these stencils. I don't see myself ordering one of these stencils for every job, but some jobs, I, you know, might be the extra little wait time and stuff, it might be worth it. Some jobs. Cool. So I'm just gonna add a drippity drop of orange to our yellow here. Now that was a few drops, but okay. What up, Pedardo? Speak of the devil, you see what I'm saying? Yeah, some jobs is the key word. Definitely any job where you gotta get it the same, it's, you know, these will help for sure. Throwing that little bit of orange in the yellow changes it up just enough. Now I'm going to take that cap off because looking back at the reference, you kind of want to rely on that stencil just a little too much, but you got to keep looking back. I got to say thank you again to Gerardo out in the chat. Sent these over. So if you guys like these live streams and like his stencils, I would say you guys thank him too. Maybe go subscribe to his channel. Right on, thanks man. We just started, so it's gonna take a while. This is, like I told you, I'm working on an illustration board today. So it's really nice and smooth, which helps the stencil bring as much detail. So like I was telling them, like even on a canvas, you lose kind of some of that detail because of the texture of the canvas. In closer so you guys can tell what I'm doing. forget the focus. The focus. There you guys go. I turned off the autofocus so it doesn't do that weird zooming in and out. But I just have to remember to keep the camera in the right spot. So. And the more I spray, the more I can notice that grid, which is kind of weird. I don't know if it's my eyes just, or if it's because the smoothness of the airbrushing is really bringing out, like, all the little stippling from the grid. I could see it a lot better the more that I spray. Yeah, making your own stencils is always good. I mean, like I said, these are like really special. And you just can't deny that. Like, these are next level as far as advancing what stencils could be and will become. This is probably the next step. Artwork always evolving, and this is probably the next evolution, or one of them at least. It's like when Mike Lavalley came out with Real Fire, right? Oh man, I remember everybody and their mama wanted to learn how to do that fire. Everybody and their mom was, I remember spending hours trying to make fire look like that. Right? And then finally, I learned from third hand. Like, somebody learned from Mike Lavalley, then I met that person, and then I learned how to do that from them properly, right? Because I did it, but it was not 100% correct or accurate. And Mike Lavalley's way, the way that I show you guys in those videos, is actually very easy, right? It's not hard. And if you follow the kind of the basic, you know, guidelines that I tell you in the video, you end up with a pretty good flame. And again, it's not truly Mike Lavalley's way. It's kind of inspired by him, but I don't know how well the person that showed me retains information. And I didn't learn firsthand from Mike Lavalley, so I can't say that it's his style, but, you know, inspired by him or somewhere along the way, you know. But you can't deny that what he did kind of changed the way people airbrushed. Not just fire, but a lot of things in general. So that's kind of where these come in, is like, you see a lot of airbrushers now, and I could mention a lot of them, that want to do like photorealism, right? And it's not really a new idea. People have been doing photorealism with the their airbrush for a long time. But what I see is a lot of people use a lot of tools to achieve these. People like Drew Blair use crayons, you know, to achieve skin tones, or colored pencils. You know, I've seen people like Rafa Fonseca. He's really relatively new onto the scene, but he's also a pretty good artist. But I've noticed in his videos, he uses like a lot of erasing. You know, he uses those machine erasers to really erase and then go back and add tones and erase and go back and add tones. And while that's all good, I believe that the true next evolution of airbrushing is stuff like this, where you maybe lay a stencil down and then you show all your freehand work into it. Or, you know, taking this and starting this as a base mode, but eventually building to the point where you build all this off of freehand work. Who comes into mind right away is like Steve Leahy. And he, I don't know if you guys have heard of him, but he does the paintings on the blades. He does like really micro paintings, but they're super detailed. And he likes doing like vehicles on blades, like literal razor blades. Small, tiny stuff. But that is a way that he's taking just airbrushing and elevating it to a point where it's not just like some random sprays, you know, or something like that. He kind of took it and he's creating stuff that is like next level. Just kind of what I feel these stencils do. So you're able to, honestly, to get to this point, right? If I was to do this freehand, to get to this point where I'm at right now with this detail, first off, I would have had to have made a stencil for the name because it's sharp. So I would have had to cut a stencil or a sticker, stick that on there, you know, then how to draw all this in freehand, and then started adding in little by little detail. And that already saved me like 2 hours just putting the stencil down and laying down a few colors. Like, that's so much time saved. And it's 2 hours for me that I have, you know, I could airbrush pretty fairly quickly, you know, but that might add up to, you know, 6, 7, 8 hours of somebody else's time, right? Somebody who's not a complete professional. So it's kind of the thing where I hate to push back against the waves. You know, if the waves are going a certain way, you got to follow the waves, man. You can't just sit there and fight the waves all day long. It'd be like arguing about electric cars. Like, electric cars are the future. Whether you like them or not, like, they're coming. They're going to take over gas vehicles and so on and so forth. Just like the regular vehicle took over buggies, you know, it's going to continue happening. And that's just the way that technology advances, you know. And airbrushing. I have a few ideas that airbrushes themselves could advance. It'd be nice. And what I'm taking a little bit of transparent gray, adding that into my yellow mixture here, which is now like orangey. But, you know, you gotta follow the trends. And if shit is changing, it's changing. There's nothing you can do about it. Like with anything, I don't expect this to take over like overnight, right? And take time, Right, so I don't expect everybody to have these stencils by tomorrow or anything like that. But, you know, don't be surprised if over the next 5 to 10 years you see a lot more people using these or similar technologies in order to achieve their paintings. All I'm saying. See, like, I already got yellow over this. I feel bad. I'm like, what am I going to do now? But I actually think yellow over the purple would look pretty good once I get there. So, might be at the very end, though. Not to mention getting the face right would have taken me forever, man. Like, I'd have been sitting here staring at the picture, looking back, adding little details a little at a time until I got it just right. And literally with the stencil, it took fucking 5 seconds to, you know, get that going. Like, I don't know if you guys can even see these little sprays I'm doing on camera, but again, it's just, you gotta try to match the detail of the stencil. The stencil will not outshine me, boy. Kind of how you feel with this. What's up, Rock? Really?
Yeah.
But you already bought some. Why don't you just go buy them back and buy another pack of those? Oh, that was the only pack?
Yeah.
Oh.
They sell out really fast.
Well, you can tell they work. So they might be worth it, even if they're a little expensive. I mean, you got the money for it. I don't know why you... Alright, last color. Let's add a little bit of black in here. You see, like, it's kind of like brown now. I don't know if you guys can see that. But we're going to add a little bit of black, and it's really going to change the color of this. I can't use that black. That's not good black. Let's do another picture, freehand and perm. Yeah, I mean, I could. So here's the thing. This area here is 9 by 11. So without even painting my version of it, I could tell you my version would not be 9 by 11. I'd be painting at least a 16 by 20, like the full thing here. Because painting something this small would take actual, literal, large amounts of time. And I would probably still have to cut a stencil for something this size. Like, it's gonna take it so long. I don't even see it, man. I gotta do some on here. Adding a little bit more reducer. Just a little bit. Yeah, small sucks. So this is one of those perfect examples where these stencils really help. If you have to paint small stuff, like if you have to paint 5 wallets and you have to put the same picture on all 5 wallets, like having one of these stencils would probably really help. Yeah. Really? It better not be the same email again. I honestly feel like I should be using a monocle to paint this because it's so dang fine. All this work just for the shirt. What's up, Easy Airbrush? Wow. Okay. It looks pretty good on the shirt, I think. So, go ahead and dump this out, wash it out. Grabbing some, what is this, light brown and dark brown. I'm gonna start with the light brown. Just put some reducer in there with the light brown. Give it a good shake. This point in the video, go ahead and tell you guys about this awesome thing called the Skull Squad. I don't know if we have any members in the chat anymore, but if you look up in the chat, you see Terry's name has a nice little skull next to it. You can join the Skull Squad by clicking on that join button, and it'll explain all the different levels and perks you get. Joining the Skull Squad helps me bring you more instructional videos like these in the future and beyond. You also get early access depending on the tier, so you get to watch the videos, not the live streams. The live streams are for everybody, but the videos, you get them a whole 7 days early ahead of time. So if that's something you might be interested in, please by all means go and join that. And if you do, I'd preemptively thank you. And so will everybody else in all the videos, because it helps bring you more videos. So. And as always, thank you guys just for watching. That helps too. If you can't afford to join, or if you just don't think it's worth it, just watching the video in itself helps. And yeah, thank you guys for watching. All the support up to this point. I like to act like you guys are helping me, but at the end of the day, you're helping yourself out, because these videos are for the people that want to learn. So if you're really interested in learning, you know, putting $2, $5, $10 is not really that much, considering you can go to Hobby Lobby and some of them videos are like $30. You might not even learn anything. I know most of you probably spend more than $5 on drink every now and then. Man, just adding that brown onto that made it look really good. It's really not detailed at all, though. It's just a layer of brown. It changed it so much. Working my way around with the brown. Light brown's one of those colors where you could, especially when reduced, you could just build it up little by little, let it dry, come back, build it up some more. For what? They have those at Sam's? For what?
Laundry
Okay. Increíble, esa malla es genial. Malla. I'm doing is adding some dark brown right into the light brown mixture. I'm not gonna add any reducer. Just adding dark brown, giving it a shake, and that way we have a shade in between the light brown and the dark brown. A mid brown, if you will. La verdad que no sé, depende del kit. Yo tengo muchos videos de los aerógrafos que recomiendo. Te recomiendo que vayas a ver mis videos. Esto se llama una plantilla. Pero sí, son muy buenas estas plantillas para hacer el mapa de una imagen, para agregarle el detalle. Esas sirven mejor que cualquier otra cosa por el tiempo que ahorita en estos tiempos, esta es la mejor manera de transferir una imagen. Really? Hello? Hey, how's it going? Yeah. A star on the point? Okay. Okay. Yeah, I'm not at my computer right now, but if you give me like a little bit later, I'll give you a call back and we can schedule it. Cool, no problem. Bye-bye. Yeah, and the more I paint, the more I'm seeing those little squares, and they're actually starting to annoy me. I'm painting to remove those squares. That's how it feels. So all my other paintings don't have those little squares, right? So now I'm like, those little squares gotta be gone. But they're part of the stencil, which makes them part of the image now. And yeah, they're starting to become more obvious the more I paint. just realized we haven't even made it to the purple yet. Ya vas a tener que ordenar, si no hay tiendas, yo todo lo que tengo es porque lo ordeno. O sea, no hay tiendas de aerógrafo. No existen. No hay tal cosa. Coast Airbrush existe, pero eso es. No es una tienda de aerógrafos. Es un negocio completo de aerógrafos. O sea, hacen más que aerografiar. Now I'm gonna dump this out. And I don't feel like I need to rinse it out because it's just light brown. I'm just gonna add dark brown clean in there with just a tad bit of reducer. Make sure to mix it up really good. like trying to fit five fingers in the size of my thumb, you know. Add a drop of black in here so we get the true dark, dark tone that I need to cover up those little squares. You guys can't see them on there, but Right on, Katana. Thank you, sir. What's up, Stephen Ward? How's it going, man? I'm doing good, man. Just trying to get this painting in. This stencil is deceiving because it makes you feel like you've already accomplished the piece of art, you know. But then you got to go back and detail it, and like I was explaining earlier, you gotta match the detail of the stencil so it actually creates more work. Yeah, man. I could see a lot of people having a love and hate relationship with these stencils. Okay, I think I'm gonna mix in just some straight black. And this time I'm gonna reduce the black. Thank you. What's up, Justice? Yo, you go. Nice little skull next to your name. What's up? And the yellow parts look pretty damn good. I think we can move on to some purple. Yeah, you can use a cameo to make some stencils. They won't be like this stencil, but, you know, for making, like, French curves or, like, certain textures and stuff, that's pretty good. So I'm gonna mix up some purple here. A little bit of reducer. Just a little bit. A lot of this purple on here is actually really dark, so. Copping more game, yeah, no, that's good, man. Yeah, if you order one of these stencils, I'd highly recommend not getting any lettering. Since it's not a mask of lettering, then when you go to add in all the detail around it, you really gotta be careful not to get any paint in those letters, man. What's up, Easy Airbrush? Thank you, sir. Damn, man. It's really coming together now with the purple. Look at it, babe. Huh? Yeah, jeez, huh? Whew, man, these are some fine lines. This reminds me, one time I got a comment. It's like, oh man, isn't there a better way than reducing the paint? Nobody wants to go over lines, you know, 3-4 times. I just had to laugh. I was like, yeah, man. Go ahead. Shoot unreduced paint. See how fine you could get those lines. Nobody wants to go over those lines 2 or 3 times. Man, wouldn't it be nice if artwork cared what I want? Man, I wish the pencil would just shade itself. Nobody wants to shade it, you know, repeatedly, all the sections. Why can't it just... This is honestly intense. So, I think that's all the purple. gonna go around the edge with a little bit of purple here. Did Kobe only play for the Lakers the whole time?
Yeah, pretty sure.
Wow, that's also kind of impressive. So a lot of those players be jumping teams like there's no tomorrow. I'm just gonna put a little bit of red in here. Go over his mouth real quick. Okay, and then mix up a little gray. Last and not but least, gonna work on grays and blacks and the whites. Yeah, it's pretty damn perfect, not gonna lie. The only thing I need now is some white highlights. That'll finish it off. Finish off our stream for today. Just 2.5 hours. Oh my gosh. How many of you guys paint for 2.5 hours at a time? Just like nonstop spraying. Sometimes, huh? Actually, this is pretty good because I've been trying to find a way to make the streams just a little bit longer. I wish I could. I just really want to get it done. Yeah. Sometimes that's how it feels. You're just trying to like, come on, let's go. You know, out of all this painting, the one thing I'm not happy with is this lettering. There's a little bit of overspray, it's not much. But when you look at the rest of the painting, then look at this. It's just not. That's one thing I would recommend you guys do if you guys can order some of these. Just make sure you don't get any with lettering, because the lettering, it's probably better to just make a stencil or like a sticker, you know, stick the lettering on there and then do the whole artwork and then unpeel the sticker so you have nice clean lettering. But other than that, it looks pretty darn good. Let's see. So let's see here, let's try to get a straight on view for you guys. Without the glare, without the glare. If I put it straight, you guys are gonna get a glare, but at least you guys get. Let's just put it at an angle. And I mean, 2.5 hours, 9 by 11 painting, having to go around this lettering here, oh man, that was a pain. But otherwise, yeah, I would say those stencils do help. I mean, if you watch the first 15 minutes of the stream, it makes it look so easy. But then you got the whole 2 hours and 15 minutes of detailing it under my hand, too. I don't know how long it would take you guys. But I think that looks pretty good. I don't think we'll need this stencil up here. So let's go ahead and let's unmask it. Let's see what it really looks like all completely unmasked. And with the white in the background and stuff. To the stencil here. I am kind of interested in doing, like, who was it that said I should paint one without the stencil and see how well that comes out. Even if it's bigger, I honestly do think I could fit more detail into a bigger piece than I was able to using the stencil. Now, using the stencil makes it real easy to get the proportions and everything correctly. Obviously, that's what stencils are for. But this masking tape is really making it extra difficult. Not one piece is going to come off and as one piece. It's all coming off in pieces. Oh, come on. Stubborn tape. Look at this. It's down to the last piece. Finally. Oh, look. There's still tape on this corner. What? Oh, my God. So ridiculous. Anyway. There you go. It almost looks like a goddamn poster. Big range of these stencils. I think you could custom make them, so whatever you want, really. So there's probably an unlimited range as far as potential goes of what you could have made. Well, I can't put you guys straight up with it because it gets the glare, but there you go. There you go. There. That's as good as it's going to get. Not moving it. Not moving it anymore. Yeah, it's actually, this is the LA Times cover for his, what they did to commemorate when he died. So, and I think they just announced today that the MVP award is now going to be called the Kobe Bryant MVP award or something like that today. So I didn't even plan it out to work like that, but I had already planned out to do this today. There you go, guys. I mean, those stencils work really good, not gonna lie. The HD stencils are nice. Obviously, you get a good result at the end. I wouldn't recommend anything with lettering because it just makes it harder. Like, even the overspray here on this purple, it annoys me, the overspray here, the little bit, you know, there. It's enough that it's noticeable to me and it bothers me. The little squares, I mean, once you cover them, they're not really that noticeable. But, like, on some spots, like right here, you could kind of see it. Around his nose, like if you look close enough, you really can see it. On stream, it's probably, you know, you can't see anything, but from my eyes right here, like even this whole arm kind of has that undershading of little squares, you know, like a silk screen kind of. But anyway, guys, I hope you guys enjoyed the stream. Thank you all for watching. As always, remember, you guys can click that join button down below. Become part of the Skull Squad. Helps bring you guys more videos like this. You know, so if you guys like this video and want to see more like it in the future, you know, it always helps. There's plans as low as $2. So, you know, not asking for much, but I am asking. I'm asking, boy. but anyway, guys, thank you guys for watching. There you go. There's the Kobe. I hope you guys like that. I like it. It's going to go up on my wall. Might go up back there. Who knows? But, yeah, we'll see you guys in the next one. Later, guys.